fundamentals at that too. Like it's very hard to play that many characters at a high level.
Seriously.
And he does it well. But like you said, playing the Wolf, I like it against the Mario as well. Very good call.
Now Mario versus Spaces is always, I feel like this would be an even matchup.
Well, Wolf Mario against Wolf, definitely. Against Fox. Wolf, a little bit different because
Wolf
of the fact that
range.
And the kill potential is there too. All these trades.
F your hamburger helper, bro. These claws are coming through.
AC is just walking up trying to read a spot dash potentially at the ledge there. These two, because of how often they play, you're going to be seeing a lot of obscure reads. But you see Stock Ticker's just keeping it simple. He's trying to just put out hitboxes where it needs.
There's that up here you're talking about.
It's like, if you can't get a big punish, just go ahead. Get that up B and fade back. You're fine.
I would not. I really could see this set going either way, even though Stock Ticker is the higher ranked player, being, I believe, top 10 in New York currently. Mm-hmm. Top 10 or top 15, I don't know. I made the PR. I don't even know what the whole PR is.
Okay, I don't remember most of them, too. But
if there's one thing Stock Ticker is good at, is catching jumps. He is very good at catching jumps in those back airs. He holds that very safe space area.
I'd say more so than even just catching jumps. He's good at realizing when you want to get out.
Yeah,
like
absolutely.
If you're in the corner.
His corner pressure is ridiculous.
Mm-hmm. You see right here, just like fading back and forth. Like that stutter step is easy to bait out options
on
people.
It's so good. With Wolf, it's incredible because Wolf has a little dirt. He just darts back and forth. Mm-hmm.
Trying to read a spot dodge yet again out of Zapros there. Zapros doing a suck.
Wow,
ooh, almost catching him. That was a perfect track that he had. Just barely missed that up smash.
Zapros kind of getting stuck in a situation that he knew he had to kind of hold shield there because Mario doesn't really have any crazy out of shield options, and he'd rather get grabbed than risk getting attacked. That being said, though, Stock Ticker doing an excellent job of catching that landing with that up smash.
There's that
right
answer
there.
You were talking about before.
Yep, there you go.
He started noticing that Zapros was trying to read a jump potentially for like a short hop down air, because if you catch a jump with Mario on the short hop down air, he's going to get a big punish there, potentially stuck. But he's being more patient, realizing that Zapros is going for those out of shield options, such as up here up smash. He's not trying to give it to him.
Stock Ticker has just been keeping Zapros in the corner, and he's been doing a very impressive amount of damage. This character is literally... Stock Ticker's corner pressure is absolutely ridiculous right now. Back throw should not wrap it up yet.
I trying to go for the cape just for the sake of putting the pressure on now.
I would have thrown a fireball out first before the cape, honestly.
Yeah, there we go. Getting the up smash read on there. Or at least the call out on the jump there.
I know Wolf's up B could probably tank through Fireball, but if you catch him on the startup, it'll pretty much always lead it to a guaranteed cape, especially at that angle.
The thing is with that too, it's conditioning in itself. If you decide to go for the cape early, it's like, all right, now I need to be safer with my jump. But then you fall asleep, and then a fireball hits you in the face, and now you might not make it back because of that weak recovery.
Oh, he still makes it back. Did he reverse that?
If that was a second.
Did he flip it the other way, or did it just?
I think he intentionally flipped it the other way, maybe because he got hit and then he went.
I don't know. That's the thing.
That might have been a huge big brain play on Stock Ticker there.
I don't know which hit it would be. I think it's actually.
Yeah, he caped him. He was facing the left. Therefore, he would have went to the left. Yeah, he
That's
was facing
what I'm saying. I don't know if it reverses at what window it reverses.
I'm gonna ask him
inputs.
That later because that definitely looked like he intentionally went the wrong way to get caped into center stage.
Because it worked. It worked. It dipped its dash tech. Yeah. Stock Ticker taking a lot of advantage right now. Zapros is disadvantaged right now.
Exactly, and the fact that Zapros, the only zoning he has is the fireball. If he just plays out of range, he's taking a few percent for fireball for the sake of holding stage positioning. Like, you have to come at me eventually. There it is, though, getting the fireball into the falling up air. No cash out on the top end, though.
Zapros has been doing a good job thus far. One thing I'd like to see him stop doing is he is very eager to reset neutral a lot of the time. This guy's a neutral enthusiast, so he'll play neutral until the cows come home. That being said, every time Stock Ticker, he's failed at a close range punish at the ledge, my man has ran across the stage. It's like Smash 4 week one. This man just running across the entire stage.
Whoa, trying to read a spot dodge potentially or even break a shield, but unfortunately there's not enough shield damage there for Zapros to get it. Trying to just fake his way down to the ground.
The thing about trying to be fancy there with your Shaw moves is that you're almost going to get caught every single time. Wolf doesn't care. Wolf can just boot you right out of there. My man's got those steel boots.
Yes.
I can picture Wolf on like a motorcycle. My boy definitely has the Harley Davidson.
He definitely has a Harley in the back for sure.
Absolutely.
But it's also one of those situations where you can keep it simple in Stock Ticker's spot there. I don't need to put an up smash out. All I need to do is just hit you with a simple up tilt or a quick trade. If you don't die, I have stage positioning still. I am a stock up. So Zapros was stuck in between the rock and a hard place there. If he can get a big lead, like an early lead in this next game, then I think his game plan of playing patient will work a lot better against Stock Ticker.
Absolutely.
Because Stock Ticker will outpatient you if he has the lead easily.
I want to see Zapros stay in his face. He's letting Stock Ticker reset neutral way too easily. My man's playing way too patiently. Like, it doesn't even. I don't think it's even patience at that point. I think it's just needlessly resetting neutral because he's in his face. He's at the ledge. Might as well trap him there. Switching to the Palu. Don't know why. The old, I just want him to switch characters. Don't know why. Maybe because of the stage.
Potentially the stage. Possibly the fact that he may have felt that that was a little bit too close for his own comfort.
Maybe.
The Stock Taker is one of those people who will purposely switch a character on you for the sake of you losing. How you just played against his wolf,
or
how
you played against his slouch. I've played against him recently. It's very, very good. Palu is one of those characters that's very easy to pick up at face value, and if you just watch what other Palus are doing, you're kind of able to emulate it almost by virtue.
Like we said, Stock Taker's pure fundamentals, like being able to just slowly weed away at your lead and make you feel very frustrated. It's a great thing to do. Right now, he's doing it yet again. Like, Zapros has been trying to fade out, but he's been getting called out on a lot of these jumps. I think that's part of why he switched. He's trying to keep Zapros grounded, and he knows the only thing he has if he's grounded is dash attack or maybe a fireball.
This match might even be worse for Mario than Wolf was, honestly.
Seems so, especially the fact that you...
Hell can really punish any single mistake you make with that.
Or
my man tried to be Twitter. My man tried to be on that Twitter video where he did the 3 million teleport cancels.
Yep, instead he's going to be on the Yeet Smash for the greatest flubs.
Top 10 oopsies. Back air. Okay, I don't think he was holding out there. I'm not too sure, though.
You know
Zapros is very tricky with these landings, but I think it's actually getting him... Because if you expect him to do the tricky landing every single time he lands, Stock Taker's going to end up catching it.
Watching the way that Stock Taker holds advantage. Like,
he
lost that stock. He did not lose a single percent in that
He stays
that
in your
thing.
Face. That's the thing.
Well, he was also just floating underneath him, like not really trying to fish for the aerial, just trying to get him to go where he wanted.
Right.
It's like, I want to push you to the corner and then make you feel so uncomfortable that you jump early or you expend a defensive resource and I'm going to make you pay for it.
You never notice, he's never going too in. My man is never too long on the track. He always lets his boy take the feature right afterwards. He's always just staying in that very close range. He'll look like he's approaching you, and he'll force you to put up your shield over commit.
Sometimes if you stay back, you can end up getting a three-peat on the basketball championship.
Exactly.
Because you can warm the bench the entire time and still walk away with three champs.
Jeremy Lin now has more NBA championships than him. And a lot of legendary
a lot of people. Emulating a very similar playstyle, is Stock Taker just kind of playing patient right now? And even though Zapros has been doing a good job of keeping it even, he hasn't really had that dominant moment yet. These have mostly just been trades. If Zapros can feel like just close out a really confident stock, like maybe a fair or maybe a good up smash, where you're trying to read a roll there instead. Like,
maybe seeing a dash attack there, not the. Zapros
like
is definitely using that SD from Stock Taker to his advantage for sure. He just teleported cancel right there. I'm a little envious as a Palu player. I can't do that. So
time to hit the lab. And it catches
up
time to
the lab. Okay, I like that. He tried baiting out the option right there. No, see, he's resetting neutral again. Hold center stage.
I see what you mean now.
He
like
keeps backing off way too much.
He keeps giving a complete reset to Stock Taker.
Exactly.
When you do that, now you have Palutena at full range. Explosive Flame is online. Auto Reticle is online.
It almost seems like he's a little too scared to get touched. I know he likes recharging his resources like blood and stuff, but most of the time, the real crispy stuff is going to be occurring in the middle of the stage.
It's just that patience that we talked about before. One of the most patient Marios you've
seen
to play.
A little too patient.
Yeah, a little bit too patient for his own for comfort, but sometimes it'll work out, sometimes it won't, just like that.
He does it again!
And then Stock Taker just gives it right back to
him.
Oh
my god. He's like, bro, I want this to be as even as a set as possible. I got you.
That was like 2 minutes for those stocks. He finally gets it, and then he just gives the stock away.
Stock Trader 69, dude. That's the 69 right there. You know, it's a yin and yang.
Just trying to... Yeah, that's exactly what that's for. He's just trying to keep it dead even for the comfort of his boy. Like you said, it is a crew.
This could get him screwed over quite a bit. Stock Taker is sponsored, though, by Gen Game, who's also manning the VGBC.
Oh, that's his jump. Oh, he was able to get by with that air dodge there and then smacking him right away with that forward smash. All of a sudden, Zapro's trying to kick it up a notch. Never mind, he's resetting. I had hope for a second there.
That flood was very interesting. I know he wanted it more of as a get-off-me tool. I don't see why he used it, though.
That was a good route that he took there, too.
Oh my god!
That could have potentially killed with how much he charged that.
Especially, it could have also killed him, because you do get, I believe, more knockback if you...
Yeah, if he gets traded right there, he's going to get the smack to the face.
Not going
to
be
not dead yet.
Oh, I thought it was like, you're still playing, bro. How's he gonna get off the ledge this time? Manages to get off the dash attack, not gonna play again. Stock Taker's been doing such a great job of playing reactionary.
Yeah, meanwhile, Zapros trying to roll his way in, but Stock Taker not taking any chances here, just keeping it super simple.
Woo! Great air dodge to get out of that. Okay, this is your chance to open up. What are you gonna do with it? Oh, he gets a roll with the up smash. Not able
Why
to.
Why did he flood there?
I don't know. Trying to force Baby stage positioning, but that's not gonna work out for him. Now he's in a spot again.
That's it.
Oh, he just runs right up, gets a down smash. But
oh no, I would have up smashed there.
Stock Taker's okay. Still alive, and he the gets a down air.
That was great. Woo! Almost gonna get any up smash to catch the get up,
and
that's gonna be it.
He closes it out, and that is completely because Stock Taker gave two stocks
yep,
away, but
did.
You gotta take advantage of that when
that's
you can.
Right. That's
Zapdos
right.
Bringing it to game three. What an intense, yet another
but
intense
he really,
match.
He brought it together at the end there. He forced the immediate get up right there because mm-hmm. he thought that's, that Zapdos was gonna stay off stage right there, and he immediately forced the option
and
to get. That is the kind of clutch play I like to see.
Finally putting a hitbox out where
Seriously,
those teleports are, too.
He stayed in his like face. He didn't run away.
He caught him on the first one, so he knew he was going to try and buffer out of there. He's like, oh, he's going for it again. I'm going to run in and immediately close this out. And he got lucky, too, because that was definitely good DI from Stock Taker going to the
clutch.
Left, and he still died. That was extremely close.
Stock Taker probably going to go back to Wolf.
Yeah.
I like the pal was working up
until he decided to press off B in center stage.
His fingers weren't working, bro.
Yeah, hopefully that doesn't occur this time where if he tries to go
it's
for
gonna
a hard
up
pretty
hard. It's going to be pretty hard for that to occur.
But you know, Stock Taker, he's going to play. Whenever stuff like that happens, he just laughs and goes
he
right
does,
back
yeah,
at it.
Yeah,
he has
yeah,
a good
yeah.
mentality
he does.
When it comes to that. Actually, no, he's going to be sticking with the Palutena.
Okay, I thought I heard Wolf, but okay.
So, excuse us. Now, here's the thing, though. Zapdos was able to turn it up on that last stock. Can he replicate that? Because throughout the rest of the match, Stock Taker had the lead the entire time.
We're back on triplats again.
I swear, if he would have tried to up B cancel and he caped that, it would have called him Mother Teresa. Like, that would have been the
greatest
read.
My man was at
read.
The barnyard. He was do-si-doing with his girl. Swing your partner around and around.
I mean, hey, we are in a music venue. He's trying to get the dance on early. Both of them playing very slow yet again, but every single time these interactions happen, it's always Stock Taker who comes out on top. If Zapdos can try and just hold
dude.
Advantage.
His ledge trapping and corner pressure has just been has simply been immaculate.
Oh,
this
that was
set.
Almost
that was
amazing.
Great.
He went for the
Whoa!
Oh, speaking of attempted reads right there.
That would have been cool. I would've
probably would have died, to be honest.
I would have stand a king off of that one.
Forcing him back off stage right there. He consistently goes for the flood, just trying to stall out off stage, and I like it because Stock Taker's giving it to him every time.
It also gives him another reset. See, I like how he uses the flood to open up his neutral. I guess he's not too confident on his approaches, so he's gonna let the flood do the work for him. Which is a good standard. Mario's approach options can be fairly limited. That explosive flame killing.
Yeah, getting buried directly in the corner there. Stock Taker noticing that. It's like, all right, you gotta hold shield or you're gonna take this in.
Exactly. Ooh, trying to two frame again with that, but that might actually eat up some damage.
Yeah,
what's the air dodge?
Yeah, unfortunately for Stock Taker, he couldn't get in position there to try and continue to establish some pressure off of that. There he is, trying to just swing with these down airs. It's a decent option on landing, and if he can catch him with that last hitbox, it will kill.
Tried to get it again. Okay, I guess he was trying to link it to the down smash off of that. Up he had a shield once again.
He threw everything in the kitchen sink at him that
Seriously.
He could. Tried to pull the whole Book of Mario, including close it out to the preach of up smash.
I mean, when Mario's not operating on those kitchen sinks, though, he's going to be throwing it at him. So,
yeah,
makes sense. Okay, trying to get it again. Okay, yeah.
I actually wasn't prepared for him to just land directly in front of him.
I want him to be catching landings a bit more, because that up smash is such a great utility for that. A little nerfed from Smash 4, but still very, very good. And
yeah.
He's definitely a kill percent for it, so I don't see why he doesn't go for it.
The problem with Zapdos right now is he's throwing in a lot of these hitboxes, just hoping to catch him at this point. All these
upbeats,
the F smashes, the up smashes, this is where Stock Taker shines. He's like, all right, cool. You want to keep swinging? I'm going to make you pay for it.
It's tough to get in, I realize, but you have to make those crucial decisions. You have to really make those crucial decisions. He's been going for a lot of these brazen movements on a shield, or just kind of using moves that aren't safe on shield whatsoever. And when you're against a player who's so confident in keeping you in one position the entire game, it can be a little rough.
Yeah, he was doing excellent with that ledge trap there, but finally made a mistake, and Zapdos made a pay for it. The down smash is going to take it. It's not like Mario can't rack up this damage really quickly.
He's camping him out. I like this a lot. He's forcing the approach, but Stock Taker's smart enough not to go too ham on it.
Yeah, you have 5 minutes left on the clock. You can, if you want to play patient, I'm going to outpatient you.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, I'm way better positioned than you right now.
Palutena, in theory, really doesn't have to push. Got the jump too. No jump left on Stock Taker. He's going to take a
good
bullet
reset as well, going
damage.
Straight to 68. So I was talking about before, that damage is easy to rack back up, but back throw's going to take it out.
Yeah, that's 2.0, baby. That's what this character is. There's one thing I've learned from watching the Great Gonzalez play is that this character is literally
just on Gons?
On Gons, bro.
Gons even here today?
There's no I don't think there's any jersey here today.
No Gons today. Stock Taker taking that position in spirit, playing very, very patiently. Catching him on a down tilt yet again. What's
That was so sick.
His consistent uses of wall jumps has gotten him out of bad situations so many times, especially in a drop-down air attempt.
He is a highly technical player. You can see these wave lands on the stage. You can see the wall jumps, the cape reverses. This man loves swagging out.
The NY crowd is super technical. I've watched him and Jewel and MGW do 10 lap matches. Like endlessly, it's so impressive to watch. But right now, he just needs the fundamentals. Gets the down.
That was
gets
sick.
The down smash.
Now one more stock needed for Zapras, but Stock Taker being one of the most clutch players I know. Hey, this is gonna be tough, but if Zapras can just take advantage of his momentum, well, this should be able to clutch this out.
Will it come back and bite him? The fact that he had those multiple SDs in game two, because all of a sudden we're looking at potentially an upset from Zapras right here over Stock Taker.
Probably a missed input on the fair right there that might cost a little bit. Oh no!
Yeah, it's only the down tilt just forces him back off stage. What's the option here? Potentially going for a nair read.
He's been a little too fancy on these recoveries. From
but he got away, and Zapros wasn't able to do anything about it.
My man is literally letting the mother effing grind decide. He's literally doing all this crazy stuff on his last stock at kill percent.
Parried all three of those again.
Okay, this is big damage for him. Oh no, he's going for these bears. Probably trying to get some sort of reset off the bounce. I'm not too sure why though. Okay, this is where it starts.
He's starting to make. He's actually burying Stock Taker in the corner now. He hasn't been able to go for these stairs. Stock Taker actually feeling probably the most stressed throughout this whole set so far.
This is looking very tough right now. Getting it back on the stage. One misplacement. Oh my god, this could be it.
If he just tries to go for.
No!
Oh, trying to read a spot dodge.
No! What are you doing?
He went for
what are you doing?
Instead of trying to keep it simple, tries to read a jump with the up B, and he makes him pay for it. Zapro's going to go down, and what a. Very tight, close set at the end of that all.
The stupid switch got jammed. No.
That's one of those. That's what separates the above average players from the professional players.
That's right.
The high level players will keep their cool, and of course, that's a stressful spot. You want to put a hitbox out there, but you put yourself in a situation where you could get whiff punished really hard. That's what's gonna happen. And he went for the up B, trying to read a potential aggressive option, and unfortunately for him, that's gonna cost him.
I feel so bad for him. Oh, that sucks.
Yeah.